you for joining us for our daily gospel reflection. My name is Maureen Demler, and I serve as deacon at St. George's Episcopal Church in Clifton Park, New York. Let us pray. Merciful God, who sent your messengers, the prophets, to preach repentance and prepare the way for our salvation, give us grace to heed their warnings and forsake our sins, that we may greet with joy the coming of Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our reading for today comes from the Gospel according to John, the 7th chapter, beginning at the 53rd verse. They each went to his own house, but Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. Early in the morning, he came again to the temple. All the people came to him, and he sat down and taught them. The scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery. And placing her in the midst, they said to him, "Teacher, this woman has been caught in the act of adultery. Now in the law, Moses commanded us to stone such. What do you say about her?" This they said to test him, that they might have some charge to bring against him. Jesus bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. And as they continued to ask him, he stood up and said to them, "Let him who is without sin among you be the first to throw a stone at her." And once more he bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. But when they heard it, they went away, one by one, beginning with the eldest, and Jesus was left alone with the woman standing before him. Jesus looked up and said to her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" She said, "No one, Lord." And Jesus said, "Neither do I condemn you. Go and do not sin again." Here ends the reading. The religious authorities have hatched a plan. They are laying a trap. They intend to prove that Jesus either does not understand the law of Moses, or worse, flouts it. Either is a serious charge and grounds for arrest. This is a story about trials. It is Jesus whom they are trying. By the end, the authorities have put themselves on trial. Each is his own judge and jury. And each finds himself guilty. This is our story. It is a story of Jesus who teaches us mercy. The world eggs us on to judge others. It expects it of us. The way of the Christian is different. The way of the Christian is the way of mercy. Like Jesus, mercy comes from God. Jesus gently invites and encourages us in living a life of humility and clear-eyed assessment of ourselves and our community. While we are constantly invited into and tempted by the world's propensity for dividing humans into us and them, good guys and bad guys, the guilty and the guilt-free, saints and sinners, in truth, we are each a little of both. Our life's work as followers of Jesus is learning and practicing gentleness, discipline, humility, and mercy. Our life's work is shaping our own lives as disciples, not judging others' lives. This is a story about what it is like to live in the presence of God, where our sins are met with divine mercy. This is good news for the woman caught in adultery, for her haughty accusers, for me, for you, and for any in whom there is even a smidgen of sin. Let us pray. Father, You are compassionate and forgiving. Like the woman in today's story, we stand amazed that you would have such mercy on us. We thank you for your unconditional love. We are not what we should be, but we accept your forgiveness and claim your salvation. Amen.